believe at every opportunity that I get, I really work with the site, you know, and try to make work that really functions within the space. And so the high ceilings here were perfect for me to be able to do the really large sales. The size of the space allowed me to create a wall, you know, with the palettes that almost would be impossible to do in a regular gallery. So all those components of the space, I was really trying to, I thought about them as I was developing the project for the space. I also wanted a projection that would be really large and people could really, could experience really up close, so that it wasn't just simply looking at a monitor. Because the imaging that I'm projecting is really compelling, but many times I want the viewer to feel like they are in that experience. And so in a way, the size of the screen could almost mimic the size of a movie theater, of a small movie theater, you know, and the way that the seating, the palettes are working like seating, it also sort of recreates the environment to a certain place. But at the same time, it's very sort of not institutional, right? It's a working environment. Everything that the sales, the palettes are sort of either commercial or industrial materials that are being used for a specific purpose. And I have one main video that is being projected into one main sale that is really large. And that video sort of chronicles what would happen to a person if they were to migrate by sea. So being in Miami, we have a familiarity with this because we all know of the Cuban rafters who make makeshift boats and then sort of take them out to sea and cross the Atlantic to be able to make it to the United States. Those who make it, we hear about it. Those who don't make it, we don't hear about it. And so I wanted to generate a video, an artwork actually, that made you aware of this and actually brought you into some sort of cognizant awareness of what it would be like if the boat crashed, if you weren't able to make it, if you were sort of destitute and lost at sea, and what that experience might be like. I'm hoping that this kind of work brings awareness to the plight of any refugee or immigrant that is traveling by sea. As you enter the space, right, you're going to have to be making a lot of decisions. The space is going to be dark. It's not going to be really well lit. So that already makes you a little bit apprehensive. The safe environment will be automatically, of course, the sitting area. It dictates sitting, so you'll know what to do at the moment. There's something being projected in front of you. So that already sets a framework for you of what you need to do, and you're not thinking. But then there are these other things, right? There's the additional sails that are also at an angle, sort of protruding into the space. And it's done intentionally to make you think that there might be something else. Behind the main sail, I'm gonna have two monitors, actually three sets of monitors on two separate walls that make like a right angle. And on those, I have two other separate videos. One, which is a video of a man that continuously makes it to the shoreline and sort of contemplates the idea of leaving, but turns around and goes back home. And sort of this video repeats itself. I'm hoping that the project will bring about a certain amount of empathy towards migrants and refugees and make people aware that anybody at any particular point by situations beyond your control, you could be placed in that situation and what that means, right? And the kind of trauma that that experience leaves in an individual.